You've got your first model imported to Source Filmmaker and are setting up your materials. Now you might run into the issue of setting up transparent elements. So let's quickly discuss transparency in Source Filmmaker, especially the most common element, the hair. Hair in video games is often created using so-called hair cards. These are segments of flat strips that make up the overall shape of the hair. Here's an example on this character model. The actual definition and detail is given by the texture and shader itself. Specifically, the hairs are painted on the diffuse and the transparency is stored in the alpha channel. Sometimes there will be a normal map to go with it for additional shading and detail. All this combined gives the illusion of millions of individual strands, but in reality comes down to a couple thousand polygons. In Source, this requires transparency to be enabled on the material itself. Otherwise, it won't even appear, even if your diffuse has a proper alpha channel. Let's take a look at our model in Source Filmmaker. Wait, this doesn't look right. The model appears fully opaque, but the geometry behind it is shining right through her. At first glance, this appears to be a transparency effect, but in fact, it's a Source Filmmaker bug related to ambient occlusion. The ambient occlusion in Source Filmmaker is calculated in a separate render pass, and since we didn't define whether or not our model was opaque when we compiled it, the ambient occlusion system doesn't take it into consideration when occluding the scene. That's why the model is treated as if it's not there, resulting in the shadows being drawn on top. We should add the mostly opaque command to the QC file and recompile our model. This appears to have fixed our AO issue. Back to our model. The next thing we see is that from one side the hair strips look opaque, but from the other it's completely invisible. This is a common optimization in game engines. A model is made of many polygons, and every polygon that is rendered, but is in fact invisible, is wasted computer power. This is why most games make use of backface culling. It is a simple, computationally inexpensive test to see whether or not a surface normal of a polygon is facing towards the camera or away from it. If the polygon appears to be facing towards the camera, it is considered for rendering. If a polygon is facing away from the camera, it won't be rendered. This works fine for most convex geometry, since the normals will be facing to the outside and the inside is always meant to be invisible. However, that means that parts of the model that are flat and have no depth, or where the normals are inverted or flipped, like the hair strips, will also only have one side visible. This presents a problem, since the hair should be visible regardless of the viewing angle. Luckily, there is a command we can enter in our VMT file for our hair that disables backface culling for the specified material. We add $nocull(1) to our hair's VMT file. Also note that in Source Filmmaker, you can reload materials using the matte-reload-all-materials console command. Slight tangent here. If you run into a situation where your entire model looks as if it's inverted when you import it to SFM, this is because the normals of your model are flipped or inverted. You can confirm this from within Blender by going to the Materials and under Settings checking Backface Culling. Your model might now match the weird inverted look you see in SFM. You can actually visualize what's happening here by going into Edit Mode and under Overlays selecting the Display Normals button. Tweak the value to adjust the size of the visualization. In this example, you can clearly see that the normals are pointing inwards and are thus inverted and displayed incorrectly. Select all the polygons, hit Alt-N, and select Flip. The normals are now pointing outwards, and once we disable Visualize Normals, it looks right again. Exporting it to Source will now show the model correctly. Optionally, you can still apply the no-cull material parameter as needed. Now, let's look at how we can add transparency to our material. There are several ways to do this, and we'll step through them one by one. The first one is the alpha parameter. This is a parameter that accepts a value between 0 and 1. Set to 0, it will render the material completely invisible, and at 1, it will be fully opaque. Any value in between will be various degrees of translucent. Here's the alpha at 0. Here's the hair with alpha 1. And here's the hair with alpha 0.5. As you can see, it's an all or nothing approach. It's a global setting for every part of the shader. This works in some cases where the entire material should be transparent, but that's not what we want, so let's remove this. You can essentially map the values of the alpha setting to a gradient, black being least visible and white being most visible. In image files, this is how transparency works per pixel. We want to put this information in the alpha channel of the image, and the brightness of the alpha channel will determine whether or not it's visible. This is very cool, since we can use this for textures on our model too. The alpha channel of the base texture controls the transparency. There are two separate parameters that we can use to enable this. Let's try the parameter that has the best quality. This is the translucent parameter. The parameter itself is just a toggle, 1 or 0. By default, it's off, so we'll turn it on by defining $translucent space 1. Once we reload our materials, there is one immediate observation that we can make. Holy damn, this looks awful. But upon closer inspection, we can see several things that are happening. Evenly shaded parts of the hair that don't overlap actually look great. The individual strands look distinct and very smooth. This is because the translucent parameter allows for fine per pixel translucency control, hence the good looking strands. However, the problems we see are caused by a sorting issue. When calculating the shading of each part of the material, Source Filmmaker doesn't know how to order the translucent elements relative to the camera. This means some polygons that should be occluded are rendered in front, resulting in annoying flickering and shading artifacts. So that's great. The best translucent shading parameter in Source is bugged. Typical. Send your complaints to gaben@valvesoftware.com. Although I'm pretty sure this won't ever be fixed. Hence we must work around the problem. There's another translucent shading parameter we haven't tried yet. Let's remove the previous one and add the alpha test. $alpha test (1). Again, immediate observation. The lighting bugs are gone. But on the other hand, the hair strands somehow look worse. The strands have gone from smooth and distinct to thin and jagged. Let's take it to Blender to understand how the alpha test parameter works. I've isolated the hair and added a color ramp in between the alpha and transparency input of the shader. I'll be swapping the alpha to the color socket here and there, so you can see how the gradient influences the final alpha. The alpha contains black and white values, as they appear on the gradient. There's not just black and white, but many shades of gray in between. All the values on this gradient represent various shades of transparency. The translucent shader does its best to blend all the in-between states between black and white. This results in nice faded strands. If we plug the alpha into the color for a second, this is clear. However, alpha test isn't as precise. Instead of dealing in midtones, it is completely black or white, visible or invisible. This is what happens if we change the color ramp to behave like the alpha test. The edges become jagged, just like we saw in SFM. Values that are brighter than the midpoint of the gradient will be mapped to full white, and thus appear opaque. The areas that are darker will be mapped to black, completely invisible. The midpoint of the gradient determines whether or not gray values will map to fully visible or invisible. Tweaking this value can drastically improve the quality of your alpha test transparency. In Source, this midpoint value is controlled using the alpha test reference. This is a value between 0 and 1. A value of 0.3 will create a thicker shape, while a value of 0.7 will create a thinner shape. Sticking to alpha test and tweaking the alpha test reference might be enough for you to get the model to look right. There is an advanced way to get the best of both worlds. You will have to sacrifice one additional material slot. Note that this is a dirty hack that you should not do if the hair is already made up of multiple materials. First, duplicate the hair mesh and rename it to add _translucent at the end. Then, on the duplicated mesh, duplicate the material and rename it to add translucent at the end of that too. Then, with only the duplicated hair selected, go into edit mode, select all the polygons and flip the normals. This means we have essentially created two separate hair layers. Now we make sure both the hair elements are in the same exportable. For me, it doesn't matter because I've chosen not to use any body groups. Exporting and compiling comes next. Let's restart Source Filmmaker to see what we have. We see our model with the famous checkerboard texture poking out from below the hair material, since we didn't create the other material yet. Duplicate the existing hair material and name it as you did with the one of the duplicate mesh. Now, in the first material, we have enabled alpha test. We set the alpha test reference to a relatively high value, like 0.7. Then, in the duplicated material, we remove the alpha test and alpha test reference and replace them with translucent 1. Let's reload our materials. That's a pretty big difference. The alpha test material provides a solid base coat that hides a shortcoming of the translucent shader. But the strands appear smoother since the alpha test reference allows the translucent parameter to take over near the extremities. You can further tweak the alpha test reference or adjust the levels on your alpha channel if the results are uneven or splotchy. We're almost done here, but I'm still seeing some weird shine-through effects around the scalp. This is, once again, very likely related to ambient occlusion. In this case, I recommend disabling ambient occlusion on the hair material. The VMT parameter for this is $ambient occlusion. Once again, this is a Boolean value, either 1 or 0. True or false. 0 disables the effect. Any changes we make to the hair must be applied to both our hair materials. Reloading Source Filmmaker reveals that the problem is fixed. So there you have it. Transparency in Source Filmmaker is not fun or good. It is one of the many headaches you'll have to deal with when porting models. One of the reasons I prefer Blender these days. Regardless, I hope this video was useful to you. I've been delighted by your comments on the previous entries in the SFM tutorial series. It seems that a lot of you have made good use of them. If you would like to see more videos like this, subscribe to the channel and support me on Patreon. A single $3 donation goes a long way and helps me keep SFM Lab up and running. And if you've made something cool, feel free to upload it to the site. Thank you for watching and see you in the lab.